Everybody, I have a counterfeit kit challenge kit build for you today. And if you've never been to the counterfeit kit challenge before, here is their webpage, and it is counterfeitkitchallenge.blogspot.com. And it's a blog post, so you have to scroll down till you find the current month challenge. It's always posted on the first of every month, and it'll be titled something like this: June 2020 Counterfeit Kit Challenge, Kit Reveal, and Blog Hop. So this month, our kit hostess has chosen an existing kit that is her inspiration. Now, you can go out and buy these existing kits if you want to support the company. However, if you need to use up supplies that you have on hand, and that's more economical for you, then you can take inspiration from things that are out there. And so these are some close-up videos, or some close-up photos, and I actually have opened each photo in a tab. So here is the main kit, and it's called Wonderful World. And I take a look at this, and this is only the second time I've participated in this counterfeit kit challenge. And so what we're going to do is look at these photos and draw inspiration, and then go to our stash and pull things that inspired us. So I'm getting an overview of things here. I'm seeing florals here. I'm seeing rainbows. I'm definitely seeing lots of watercolor effects. We've got some pops of bright yellow, some softer blues and some greens, some pinks. I'm seeing something that maybe looks like hearts, more rainbows here. This appears to be possibly hearts, maybe mothy butterflies. Here's a Vicky Booten ephemera pack, which I actually already own in another kit. There's some labels here and kind of a rainbow of color. Anything in rainbows of color make me really happy these days. I'm seeing a little bit of pops of black, and then down here there's some squares with kind of a color palette. So let's take a look at some closer pictures. Here's more of a close-up of the kit. Ooh, look, this caught my eye right here, these houses, and it's definitely on kind of a watercolory mixed media background, so that definitely caught my eye. I know I have some stamps in my stash that are houses, so that's the first place my brain is going to. We've got some fibers, kind of everyday word. Now the houses and this everyday word make me think of all the time we're spending at home every day. So that's kind of where my brain's going there. Butterflies. Okay. Let's keep looking at the photos and see what else we can come up with. It's just kind of a close-up. I see a star here, a little bit of pops of black, wander. I'm not doing much wandering these days. Oh, here's some craft tags. Okay, so that's an element. And then even closer on that. Now here are these labels. These labels speak to me. I definitely want to incorporate some labels into things. Oh, little tiny envelopes. And this makes me think of, I have a tool that's a tiny envelope maker by We Are Memory Keepers. So maybe I want to pull out my envelope making tool. And then I already have this embellishment pack, so that's not really speaking to me right now. Rainbows. I just got a stamp set that's rainbows. So maybe I can incorporate those. And then there's a stamp set, so that definitely speaks to me. So let me go ahead and head to my stash and pull up some of these elements that spoke to me. And I can say right now that I know these tags are speaking to me. I know that is not, that is not speaking to me. So I'm going to close that tab. This is definitely speaking to me with those tiny envelopes. And then if we head back to here, this house paper and this word every day is where I'm going to coalesce my kit around. I am very much interested in having a stay-at-home kit. So let's get started on that build. Okay, I have started pulling items out of my stash, and I'm starting with this blank stack of heavyweight cardstock, and it's a Park Lane product that was from Joann's. Now this is 110-pound, and I cannot find this on their website anymore. It's a very, very smooth, thick cardstock, and I am pulling this out because I am taking that watercolor element of the inspiration kit really to the max. So any color that's coming from this kit is going to be heavily about watercolor. Now, those labels that I really loved, I realized I have a label stamp and die set. So I'm going to reproduce my own embellishments, and this is going to be true throughout the kit. As we get in deeper, you'll see how I am going for a very homemade, embellished, and home-colored kit. Next up is this rainbow stamp set that I said that I had in my stash, and this one is actually a newer product, so that one's still available. That's from Concord and Ninth, and I will put links to anything that's still available in the notes below. And I decided, since I'm working with stamps and a lot of watercolor elements, I think I want to do my own titles using stamps and dies this time. So I pulled out, I believe this is a Lawn Fawn set. I'm not sure if it's still available or not. So that is going to be for my title letters. Now, the core of this kit that's going to be about the theme of staying at home is this pile of stamp sets. And this first couple of sets is from a company called Three Room Studios out of Canada. And that set very specifically is about the cozy at-home feeling. This set has some furniture pieces and some themes around books, which I've been doing a lot of reading lately, as I know a lot of people have. I also pulled out a kitchen set of stamps, and I believe that's Technic Tuesday. Yes, there it is. And it's got a die to go with it because we've been doing a lot of cooking at home. I also pulled out a stamp set with chickens in it because we used to raise chickens and we had taken a break for a little while, but with being at home so much, we went back to raising chickens. And then I pulled out one of these stamp sets. Now, these last two stamp sets are from Art Impressions, and that last one had a house on it. But here's the other house stamp set that I had mentioned before, and that one is an older Stampin' Up! Product. So I pulled out a whole bunch of word and sentiment stamps also that have little phrases on them like cozy, right now, at home, reading, cooking, listening, watching, because we're doing a lot of those things lately. And these are just some random stamp sets from my stash, from old kit clubs, things like that. So I don't have brands for you on everything here. The three roller stamps, there's two Studio Calico and one is a Chamel stamp. Now, the elements from the kit inspiration of florals and butterflies, I pulled in with this set. It's a Vicky Booten watercolor sticker set, and so that brings in the watercolor theme. It actually brings in Vicky Booten products, which was one of the inspirations, and so I've gotten all those pieces there. And then I wanted to pull in some of that craft element with some of these stickers. Again, they're just phrases about everyday life, and I figured those might come in useful. There's also white ones that I could end up coloring with, and I can layer all these sentiments on with those tag dies that I plan on making. And then here is my mini envelope maker by We Are Memory Keepers. This product is still available, and it makes envelopes up to about 4 inches by 4 inches. And I haven't played with it too much, so I'm really excited to put that to really good use on this kit and create some of my own embellished elements. Now, here is a roll of twine. This one is a natural twine. I do plan on bringing in a white roll of twine as well. I just couldn't find it when I was recording. So the next element I have for you is a tiny bit of pattern paper. I wanted to be sure to have at least a little bit of color and texture for layering pieces. And this is a Lawn Fawn pattern paper, and it's all the exact same print. It's just in a range of soft colors, which I think work well with a watercolor. And then this is a Simple Stories. It's an older product in much more bold colors. So I wanted to have that option between the soft watercolory look and some bold accents and some different patterns and textures. So just a little bit of pattern paper for this kit. And then some sprinkles of embellishments. I pulled out some white kind of matte enamel dots and some black matte enamel dots to add in that pop of black that I noticed in the kit. And then a lot of my watercoloring is actually going to be done with this marker set as opposed to watercolor paints. So I will show you some tips and tricks and techniques for watercoloring stickers, for using markers on your stamps, for water, using markers to make your own kind of paints. So I will show you a lot of these tips and tricks as I bring you back projects. Now, if you see that little pop-up window there, one thing that I forgot to pull out was some watercolor paper specifically for doing some stamping watercolor effects. So here is what I've got to work with. It seems like a lot of stuff, but the stamps really give us a lot of flexibility to build our own embellishments and build our own colors, which I'm excited about. I plan to be back with a couple more videos this week with projects and tips and tricks, so join me then. If you enjoyed this video, please do give it a like, and if you'd like to see my future videos, subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss anything. Thank you for joining me.